A beautiful woman with long, tightly curled hair walks down a city street in a tight black dress and high heels. The scene catches Michael Jackson's eye and ignites Jackson's pulsating, sexually charged 1987 track, The Way You Make Me Feel. The single and accompanying music video was used as a vehicle for Jackson to portray a more adult, virile public image. With its undeniable chugging locomotive groove and Jackson's incessant hooting, hollering, and crotch-gyrating moves, The Way You Make Me Feel stands today as an infectious signature track for Jackson and continued the Bad Album's groundbreaking chart success. This is the story behind the inspiration, production, and commercial reaction to one of pop history's most iconic music releases, Michael Jackson's 1987 hit, The Way You Make Me Feel. The inspiration. No longer the cherubic, brown-skinned moonwalker everyone wanted to emulate, Michael Jackson, now 29 years old, had grown up and his Peter Pan image had worn thin in the public eye. By 1987, Jackson had gone from critics' darling during the Thriller era to the media's biggest target. His lightened skin and slimmed-down nose caused many in the black community to question his solidarity with them, and his eccentric behavior, feminized appearance, and lack of tangible female pursuits only added fuel to the fire of his most damaging public rumor, one that irked Jackson before, that he was in fact homosexual. Knowing this would be a glaring public issue during the conservative Reagan years and the homophobic hysteria caused by the AIDS crisis, moving forward, Michael Jackson's team were keen to portray an artificial macho demeanor, for Jackson to shed his otherworldly image and attempt something more relatable in order to make him appear more heterosexual. Previous to the Bad Album, Michael Jackson had sung about girls in songs like Rock With You and P.Y.T., but The Way You Make Me Feel would be the first song that displayed Jackson as an aggressive pursuer. According to the documentary Bad 25, the song and subsequent video was intended to show another aspect of Michael Jackson. In addition to his reputation as a lover, with the track I Just Can't Stop Loving You, him being streetwise and bad, Michael Jackson's inner circle also wanted to portray him as somewhat of a womanizer with the ability to pick up girls. The production. The Way You Make Me Feel was written by Michael Jackson himself. Previously, Jackson wrote many of his hit songs, including Billie Jean and Beat It. This is another example of one he wrote. Although it's not nearly as personal as many of his previous compositions, he wrote this track after his mother Catherine asked him to write something with a shuffling kind of rhythm. In addition to writing the song, Jackson also co-produced the track with Quincy Jones, his longtime collaborator who also helmed his Thriller album. Before the recording of Bad, Jackson had written over 60 songs for the record with plans of releasing a 3-disc album, but Jones later convinced Jackson to make Bad a 1-disc LP. Therefore, The Way You Make Me Feel, as well as 10 other songs, were selected for the complete album. Quincy Jones has said this song is one of his favorite orchestrations on the album. Lyrically, the song is very simple, but Jackson amped up its complexity with his own signature ad-libs, and Quincy added lots of little rhythms and sounds to the track to give it texture. The music video. In the short films for the Bad Album, Michael continued to expand the possibilities of the music video as an art form, working with high-profile collaborators to realize his artistic visions. Acclaimed commercial director Joe Pidcook made his mark on the music video with films for both The Way You Make Me Feel and Dirty Diana. The Way You Make Me Feel was filmed in early September 1987 on a Hollywood soundstage that was made to look like a run-down, sketchy part of New York City. The video was designed to show off a more flirtatious and romantic, yet still edgy side of Michael. However, it begins with Jackson as an outsider, a stranger in both the worlds the video presents. In the full version, the video begins with a group of men trying to pick up women unsuccessfully. One of those men, Michael Jackson, is told to go home and not to hang around with the other guys anymore. Dressed simply in black pants, a white t-shirt, and a long-sleeved royal blue shirt with a white sash tied in a bow at the front, Michael Jackson looked like a backup dancer from a classic Gene Kelly musical. When Jackson starts to walk home, an elderly man who is on the steps of his building sits him down and confronts him, telling him to just be himself. Jackson then notices a woman, played by model and dancer Tatiana Thumsen, walking down the streets alone. Shortly after, Jackson stands in front of the woman while she's attempting to pass. Although she ignores him and keeps walking, he grabs her attention by shouting and then begins aggressively serenading her while also dancing. Uninterested, she walks away, and the director's camera spins around Michael Jackson as he follows her. He is persistent in his pursuit of the woman and continues to gyrate, thrust, and grab himself while being cheered on by his friends. Thumsen then takes refuge within a group of other females as the male and female spectators start making remarks and jeering at each other. Michael Jackson's sister, LaToya, is featured as one of the female friends, having previously appeared in the music video for his single with Paul McCartney, Say Say Say. In the final video, Tatiana became sexual prey and Michael is chasing her. The car becomes a sexual symbol, a hidden place where everything can happen. Jackson had apparently handpicked her himself out of 200 women who applied to play his video ingenue. One of the reasons he chose her was because he wanted a girl to whom he felt a real sexual attraction with. Speaking about the subject, Jackson said, quote, "That's why it is my job to cast the girl, because it is my job to think they are cute." Jackson then eventually leads a silhouetted synchronized dance routine with several other male characters, backlit by a soft blue light. The video ends with Michael eventually winning the woman over and embracing her while a fire hydrant sprays out water behind them. The video was choreographed by Jackson and longtime collaborator Vincent Patterson. Even though this was an expensive video with a high production value, it was important for Jackson that it looked gritty and natural. This was done by the documentary style of it, as P.Y.T's use of handheld moments made the audience feel like they were seeing Michael Jackson's dancing skills in real time, and also a real sexually charged interaction between him and Thumsen. For additional authenticity, Jackson featured two real American gangs as extras, one of the gang's members being part of the Crips from Los Angeles, California. Much like in his Beat It music video, where a host of rival gang members were featured in the video's climactic face-off. After the five-day video shoot wrapped, Michael Jackson flew immediately to Japan to begin his first leg of his Bad World Tour. On September the 20th, 1987, after performing in Osaka City, Nishinomiya, Michael returned to the hotel to watch for the first time the director's cut for the short film of The Way You Make Me Feel. The version with a long introduction did not please Michael much. Therefore, he sent instructions for the director to refine the video, totaling 9 minutes and 33 seconds to a much shorter edit. Today, this shortened edit is the most common version of the Way You Make Me Feel music video. The release. Epic Records released The Way You Make Me Feel as the third single from Michael Jackson's Bad album on November the 9th, 1987. The single climbed to number 7 on the Billboard Hot 100 the week of December 26th. After charting with the top 10 for 5 weeks, the song peaked at number 1 on the Hot 100 on January 23rd, 1988. The Way You Make Me Feel became the Bad album's third consecutive single to reach number 1 on the Hot 100. The music video received a nomination at the 1988 MTV Video Music Awards ceremony. The video, alongside Jackson's Bad video, was nominated for Best Choreography, but lost to Jackson's younger sister Janet's video for her single, The Pleasure Principle. Michael Jackson performed The Way You Make Me Feel at the 1988 Grammy Awards, during which Jackson wore his signature outfit and black fedora while performing a dance routine with four other dancers, which was also staged and choreographed by Vincent Patterson. Jackson's video love interest, Tatiana Thumsen, also appeared on stage during the televised performance and later joined Jackson on his Bad World Tour. However, after only a few shows, Thumsen states that she was fired from the tour by Jackson's manager, Frank DeLeo, after an incident during one of the performances in which she approached Jackson and kissed him on stage in front of an audience of thousands. From then on, singer Sheryl Crow filled in for Thumsen. As she was already on the Bad tour singing with Jackson, "I Just Can't Stop Loving You," she told Rolling Stone in 2010, quote, "There'd be some nights where he was checked out, but some shows he'd pulled me in really tight, and it was overwhelming. Not in a sexual sense, but because of the metaphysical energy he possessed." The Way You Make Me Feel was a popular track for Michael Jackson's subsequent tours, and Jackson's last public performance of the song was at the 30th anniversary celebration in 2001 at Madison Square Garden. when one night, he performed the song as a duet with Britney Spears. Britney's appearance was originally cut from the broadcast because of her contract with HBO, but was inserted for a re-air of the special on CBS in November 2001. Michael Jackson had apparently admired Britney Spears from afar for years and would talk to friends about how sexy and beautiful the young star was. It has been said that the televised performance was set up as a way for the King of Pop and the newly crowned Princess of Pop to finally meet. Britney Spears was a fan and has fond memories of their brief interactions with each other.
I didn't really realize what had happened until I got off the stage, and I was like, I just performed with Michael Jackson, man. It was just really an amazing experience for me because The Way You Make Me Feel, that's the song that I performed with him. It's one of my all-time favorite songs. So it was awesome. It was really, really amazing. I was very honored that he wanted to do the song.